Here's a funny thing. The Monty Hall problem is one of the most famous counterintuitive problems, yet it's based on something that never even happened. Look, for now, we'll just go with the story.
Welcome back to Let's Make a Deal. I'm Monty Hall. I've got with me now a contestant. What's your name?
Bernard.
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 Okay, Bernard, and where are you from?
Benedict County.
Oh, that reminds me of a very ill man I once knew. He went to see his doctor, who told him to spend some time in Benedict County. The man said, "Will that help me live longer?" The doctor said, "No, but it'll certainly seem longer." Okay. Let's play the game.
Monty would invite a contestant to choose one of three doors. Behind one would be a car, and behind the other two would be something that you wouldn't want. Traditionally, it's a goat.
So, Bernard, which door do you want to choose?
Door number one.
Okay, he's going for number one. Let's have a look.
Then he'd always open one of the doors that hid a goat. Now, the problem is this. Should you stick with your original choice, or should you switch?
So, Bernard, you know it's not behind door number three. So, do you want to stick with door number one, or switch to door number two?
The answer is, you should switch. Why? I'll show you why. Here I have three mugs, and under one I've placed a small onion. And I ask you to guess which mug it's under, and you randomly choose this mug here. The chance of it being here is 1 in 3, or more importantly, the chance of it being here is 2 in 3. If I asked you if you wanted to switch from the one you'd picked to both of the others, you'd see it would make more sense to do so. If I add more items to the choice, you'd see the odds wouldn't change. I could add a tea bag, a packet of crisps, or even some more mugs. But that won't change how likely it is that the hidden onion is here or there. Therefore, when I take away the items that we know make no difference, it's clear that the odds won't change. I also know that this empty mug will make no difference. I'm taking it away because it's empty. I know it's empty and it is not being randomly removed. The odds still haven't changed. It's perfectly understandable to disagree with this, but that's because it's famously counterintuitive. It goes against what seems correct. So, let me make it more clear. This time, we have 50 cups and mugs, and I ask you to guess which one is hiding the onion, and you choose this one here. The chances of you randomly guessing it correctly are 1 in 50. I then give you the choice. Do you want to switch to all of the remaining 49? Well, of course you do. Then I remove 48 of the 49, which I know definitely do not contain the onion. I think you'll agree, it's very likely the onion is here. So the point is, if the doors were chosen randomly, then it would make no difference which you chose. But they weren't, which is why, in the case of the Monty Hall problem, your chances of winning increase from 1 in 3 to 2 in 3 if you switch. But as I said at the beginning, none of this ever happened. Monty Hall never did this on his show, and this puzzle has been attributed to him rather randomly.
Bernard.